Mississippi and New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden league. This team is off the hook and you don't really want none. But if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some. But you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. I can't be touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0, Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard, my team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is, I get it. I got cleats on my feet, jersey on my back, helmet on my hair, ready to attack like that. Down in Mississippi and New Orleans, Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden league. His team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world this is Madden territory. Come get some if you want some. But you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons. Bag up off me and watch it lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. I can't be touched and I can't be schemed.
All right, much appreciated, Coach, as we welcome all of you to our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Just as we were ready for air, it was the Colts emerging from the locker room to great fanfare here in Indy. They're ready to go as the Colts get set to match up with the Tennessee Titans. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? Are you ready?
Get ready, dog.
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air.
Switching these flows, if you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm starting to tell you the vessels alone. They showing me love in my city, gangs ain't hippies. Women like Nicki know what I'm about. I'm not the stereotypes, they do not fit me. I'm bigger than life, give everyone dogs. I'm not a guard, go hard with a squad. I'm playing my part, but I'm LeBron. Rings of the team, I feel Jackson and hard. The homie calling from a cell, a couple of homies be making it. Making it. I just want all of them dudes to do well, and I'm worried about taking a couple of L's. No sin for me, just win for me. Don't kill for me, just live for me. Keep it real for me, we eat together, leave the bill for me like.
Hand on my heart, I give it all I got. Walk the walk inside the talk. Take a higher, that's a God. Hand on my heart, no, I give it all I got. Walk the walk, talk the talk. Take a higher, that's a God. Never stopping, that's a must. Always winning, never lost. GPS, I never lost. GPS, I never lost.
Who do it better than me, yeah. Vision on 2020, yeah. BBS, Club of D, yeah. Determination, laser focus, banging on they, though they taking notice, taking notice, taking notice.
All right, coach, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Just a short time ago, smoke from the pyrotechnics filled the dome as the Colts made their way out of the locker room. We're set for football as the Colts get set to match up with the Tennessee Titans. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in Week 13. Fielded about a yard deep. NC State, Nyheim Hines. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Brissett sets to throw it. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down.
Let's go. Let's do this.
So instead of fourth down, first down.
Well, so much for winning the down you put a lot of emphasis on, because third down is key for offense and defense. Instead, you're going to stay on the field and start a new set of downs.
A big play there on the option. 44 yards. So he rips off a great run and shows you why this year he's top 10 in rushing in the league.
And looks like he's trying to move up fast on the leaderboard, doesn't he? Top 10? Looks like he's ready to get into the top five.
He's got it to Hilton. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and you can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam.
So not quite a first and goal just yet as they come up now second and inches.
All day, every day, any day.
Here's Hines. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. They'll say no gain on the play, so it was looking good, but nothing there. Now it's third down and inches.
It's now third and less than a yard.
On the double. Got 55. Hey, let's get in Hines.
On third down. It's Hines, and he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Just a yard, but that's all they needed, and by the slimmest of margins, it'll be first and goal.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
Run it! Mark by four. I got you, son! Jump on! Hey, alert three! Tighten up.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stock troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. They'll try to throw now. Brissett. This is caught. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Paris Campbell with touchdown number 7 on the year. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Vinatieri connecting on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at the 20. Now a first-time 1,000-yard rusher from a season ago. It's Derrick Henry. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
6-3, 218, chop.
Derrick Henry. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker. Not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward, since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school, he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
Why? Get wide. Check three. Hey, check 24. Watch 24. Get him off. Yes.
They'll start on the ground with Hines. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. From the gun, here's Brissett. Catch made here by Campbell. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. First down, Brissett. Campbell making the catch. Man able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A gain of 11 that time and a Colts first down.
Exit.
Quartet, Quartet, Quartet.
Just one.
Tight door.
On first down, Hines. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And finally taken down at the 34. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down. One thing's for sure, this defense has to figure out how to stop the ground game. He's eating him up here in the first quarter.
It looks like they have to go to different forces, aren't they? The conventional things aren't working too well. So I remember a coach of mine saying way back when a back's having a great game, you've got to get the ball out of his hands. See how far he can run without the ball. And what he meant was takeaways, knock it loose, because maybe you can't just stop him with just regular tackling.
And a short gain down to about the 33. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the Titans' 33-yard line.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Throwing. Brissett. He's going to let this go end zone for Hilton. And he's got his man. It's Hilton for the Colts touchdown. T.Y. Hilton. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Vinatieri able to tack on the PAT, and that'll make the score 14-0. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon.
And that's intercepted. It's Darius Leonard, the 2018 Defensive Rookie of the Year. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. That's now his 2nd interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. To throw is Brissett. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And a great return as he's up close to the 40-yard line.
Boy, that's the kind of interception that can save a game right there. They're already down 2 scores. Huge play, slowing down what was going against them.
I was thinking the same thing. You get down 3 scores there at this stage, could be in for a long ball game. After the interception, here's Tannehill. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a 2nd down and 17. To throw is Tannehill. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, 3rd down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on 1st down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
Third and long. It's Tannehill. Got a man. It's Brown. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And he was called on three times in the win last week as his first one hears away. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. It's been a good first half so far. They're up 14-0. Points here, that could really put them in command before intermission.
Yeah, and it's all well and good what they're seeing and how they're feeling right now. But this is the NFL. How many times have we watched 14-0 leads evaporate and quickly? So how have we seen them combat it? Continue to run your offense, but don't back off at all. Don't start looking at the clock. Don't start thinking about, hey, just take care of the football. Keep attacking, usually the best way to maintain control.
On second down, it's Hines, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd-and-11 situation. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces 4th down. Very good return that time. 18 yards, and it'll be Titan football. An NFL update there in the second quarter in Baltimore. And the 49ers are out to the early lead. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10. On 1st and 10, Tannehill. That's complete to a speedy wideout, Goodwin. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 17 yards on that play for the Titans. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for 2nd down. So they had the big loss on that 1st down pass play and facing a 2nd and long. Tannehill. Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Marquise Goodwin, touchdown number 18 on the year, as they are now on the board here in the first half. Extra point up and good by Succop, and that'll make our score 14-7. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity for them to go down there and put up a couple of sixes back-to-back. What a momentum swing that would be.
Yeah, you might be able to get a two-for-one without ever even giving up the football. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. He came out ready to play. That's three tackles for a loss, Charles. We're only in the second quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. You might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball. We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Third and short yardage, Brissett looking deep for Hilton, and this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, Indianapolis. T.Y. Hilton with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. That's a pretty quick response to that last touchdown drive, and it seemed like they maybe given up momentum. Not so fast.
No, not at all, because they ended up pushing the lead up once again, and you're exactly right. Thought momentum might have been shifting. Instead, they grabbed old Mo, didn't let him get to the opposite sideline.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Well, look at the clock here. You're inside of a minute. First half hasn't gone that well for you. How are you going to play this drive?
Well, I've been told by my coaches previously that the intelligent approach, go ahead and run out the clock and start over. Don't make any more mistakes. But there's also something to understanding that you've got this last drive here. You get the ball to start the second half. Try to go 2-for-1 here. Get some points now and come out of the locker room and get more points again and get your momentum really built up.
Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
They kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
From the 21, it's second and 10.
Look at me, zipper! Hey, exit! 45 to 9. Watch the run! Hey, they're running, man! 45, 45, 45, 45.
Now Tannehill. He's going deep for Brown. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, but they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. First try for the right arm of Dalton here. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Now the Colts will use their third and final timeout, as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. Here's Brett Kern now, as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before.
That's caught at the 25. Touchdown, Indianapolis. T.Y. Hilton. As the first half is winding down. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Fielded about a yard deep. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will. I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will it be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'm going to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
They go 3-3-68.
Passing again. Dalton on second and 10. This will be caught by Brown. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never wanted to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Now, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin. But now it's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now a deep ball going to be caught here near midfield. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A pickup of 27. And they pick up the first down in the process. From midfield here, Dalton. Complete. This is Lewis. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down. Andy Dalton now 3 out of 5 since taking over as he's given his guys a first down. To throw here, Dalton. It's caught by Davis. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. They'll try and run for it with Henry. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Derrick Henry, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Titans are able to cut into that deficit. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense.
And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away but could not. Cameron Wake, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Mike 55.
Looking to throw on second down. Reset. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Jayon Brown able to record his fifth sack of the season.
So, Brandon, we've sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
It's third and long for Brissett. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Jarrell Casey. The offensive line is in tatters as that's now 3 sacks and 3 plays. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he'll take it on this side of midfield. A great blocking nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And the Titans are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over first and 10. A check of the scoreboard there in the third in Baltimore. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses.
I'm here all day.
58, right over there, right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike, 58, right there.
You go right there. Go right there.
Fight it.
You remember me? Let's go, baby. Under 10.
There you go, 368.
They'll try and get the run game going. This is Henry. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Unfortunately for you, you've been around me for a little while now, so you know me as well as anyone and how I look at a game. I don't ever advocate abandoning anything, but in this case, I'm going against my own thought process. You've got to change it up. You got to start throwing it around a little bit, finding ways to try and move the ball, because keeping on the ground just isn't working for them.
Yeah, maybe get him the ball out of the passing game, a swing pass outside or something, just something to vary it up. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. For the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. He's got Lewis. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football.
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line.
And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Marquise Goodwin with his 19th touchdown, his 2nd of the game, as his guys are back within a single score. Extra point put through by Suckup, and they're within 7 now at 28-21. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This will be taken very short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Indy offense at the line and set. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Here's Brissett. He's got it to Hilton.
And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Well, that's one of the drawbacks of running the RPO. If those linemen go into run block mode, you can't throw it if they're more than a yard downfield. Going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second down now, it's Hines. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Charles, you'd said the magic number was probably right around 20 for this defense because they're facing one of the top five offenses in the league in terms of points scored. They've had their moments, but this offense, just a little too good, isn't it?
They really are, because no matter what you do to make an adjustment on defense, they've had an answer for it.
On third down, Brissette. And he's got his man, Hilton. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. T.Y. Hilton, 66 yards. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. And let's count them up now. 1, 2, 3, 4 touchdown receptions for him in this game.
And just one shy of the NFL record. What a great performance. Going up and catching the football, creating space, and finding the end zone. That's what it's all about.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. He'll get this one into the hands of Lewis. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 yards there, a first down. Andy Dalton now, a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad, first and 10. Now Dalton, and a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on.
Let's go, baby.
So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
General West. 93, 52, 93, 44. 44. There you go.
SOS.
Hey, Charlie.
And it'll be Dalton again. Now this is intercepted. He was trying to get it to Davis. Picked off at the 22. He's at the 30. The 20. 10. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20.
The Titans take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Yeah.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Second and nine now from the 21. Play fake. Here's Dalton. He gets it to Humphreys.
I got you, boy. I got you, boy.
And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. The Titans get 14 yards there and move the chains as well. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Dalton here from the gun. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Throwing again, Dalton. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick, and it's third down. Another incomplete pass there. What do you take from this game offensively?
Well, you know it's tough to really analyze for them because it is a team game, right? And let's be honest, though. The defense did them no favors in this one at all. Offense actually moved the ball. So, bottom.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll attack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
And some room to roam now. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Naeem Hines. His 19th touchdown now on the season. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Titans' offense set to begin the drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. On second and nine, Dalton caught right side. It's Lewis. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing on the screen that time. Now it's third down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. Running from the gun with Henry. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down.
It's been a struggle this entire game trying to move the ball on the ground. But every now and then you find a little chink in the armor, and that type of run right there lets them know that they can't stop every single run for almost no game.
And he locates Walker, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
I got you.
On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. Now a desperation. This is caught at the 20. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 36 yards on the play. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Dalton toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Now, he's been a busy man out of the backfield. They've looked his way quite a bit so far in this game.
Nice job there defensively, though, adjusting, because a couple of his earlier catches, he was wide open. Not that time.
You mentioned the key word, adjustment. A better cover man on him now in space.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. So Dalton now. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. He was looking for the rookie A.J. Brown there, but now it'll be third down. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10.
Move. Hey, four down. Hey,
another chance for Dalton. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try on fourth. Here's Dalton. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And that will write a finish to this ball game. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but.